Welcome to MD, how to study math. In this video, I'd like to discuss briefly about what mathematics is, why it is exciting, why it is sometimes hard, and how you can improve your learning process. So, what is mathematics? There are many answers depending on your point of view. You can view mathematics as a language or as a tool, an art or science. But I like this definition of mathematics as study of patterns and relationships. Pattern of numbers, that's arithmetic. Geometry is the pattern of shapes. Calculus is the pattern of changes, and etc. Math is exciting. Math has been successfully applied to different areas, many different areas, from science to technology, natural and social phenomena. But more importantly, math gives you better ways of thinking, better ways of problem solving, and it's kind of give you a shortcut of doing things. For example, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. It's easy for fewer numbers, but more numbers, a lot of numbers, might be hard. But you see a pattern, you can group these additions into pairs. 1 and 10, 2 and 9. So there are 5 pairs, each is 11. So addition from 1 to 10 is 5 times 11 equals 55. Now, having found this shortcut, you can apply this to any number, 100, 1000, 1 million, you can solve it in the same way. And understanding of pattern also gives you understanding of nature itself, how things work. For example, you're wondering, why is the shape of a honeycomb hexagon? Why is it not a triangle or a square? Because it is the most efficient. A hexagon uses the least amount of length, that's perimeter, to store the maximum amount of area. That means the bee is efficient using the least amount of wax to store the most amount of honey. So with the same length, hexagon has the most area. Math is hard. I believe that everyone can learn everything, anything. But difficulties in learning math might be because of the learning gap. In order to learn some topics in math, you require to have some good understanding of more elementary and foundational topics. For example, a building, if it has shaky foundation, the building might crumble. Likewise in math, you might have difficulties doing algebra if you don't have good understanding of arithmetic, for example. So it's important that the student fill in the gaps, and also the student must have the good motivation to learn math. And I advise students to do more active learning, because the more active you are, the more understanding and learning that you get. So students should start with simple examples, develop intuition and ways of thinking, and slowly move to more complicated problems and examples. And it's very important to be active, and I advise students to tell stories, to communicate the way of thinking. Sometimes thinking out loud or write down your work, that should help to improve your understanding. And don't be afraid to make mistakes. Mistakes are just part of learning. And I have seen students think differently. Some are better with verbal communication, some are better with pictorial representation. So in understanding, for example, in early stages of learning about addition, student might find it better using counting objects like this. Some other student might be better with the number line representation. Which one is best depends on the student. And in multiplication, some students are more comfortable using this method. Some are better using the area model. So 20 plus 3, 30 plus 5. Altogether, there are like 4 multiplication, and you add them all together, you get 805. The same. Some are developing the grid and lines model and should come up with the same answer. Which one is best? The one that you really understand. And it's very important to understand the story of the problem that you're doing, and it might help to draw pictures or diagram, anything that help you understand the problem better. For example, this problem involving time. So you draw a timeline to better represent the problem. Like this is the situation now, and this is the situation 5 years ago. Now father is 5 times Andy. 5 years ago father is 9 times Andy. But 5 years ago father is F minus 5 and Andy is A minus 5. So you try to solve this problem, then you obtain the solution is A equals 10, so Andy is 10 years old now and his father is 50 years old. Now this is the big picture of what you're learning from primary school up to junior and senior high. Primary education students mostly learn about numbers and shapes, some basic statistics, pre-algebra, simple equation, and as you move to junior high, more algebra and more complicated equation, system of equation, multivariable, quadratic equation, and so on. And in high school, you will learn about calculus, definition of limit, continuity, differentiation, integration, and so on. In next videos, I will discuss some of these topics. Please comment if you have some topics that you would like to be discussed. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Bye.